there is one brand that I have not featured on my channel at all, and I know a lot of you had requested. So finally, I am thrilled, as you can read in the title. These are butter lipsticks from Chambord Orosa, and I am thrilled to bring all those 6 shades to you, because I think that I had tried one of them which I really liked, and I thought that somehow this was something like ColourPop's crayons that I had featured on my channel before. If you've not seen that, I'll link that above, and I'll take you through these 6 shades. I'm Aparna Ganesh, and I welcome you back to Joy Geeks. If you're new here, I create beauty and wellness content. I love creating a lot of lipstick swatches, and you love it too, amongst other makeup and beauty related things. This is another lip swatch video, and I'm going to straight dive into what I think about the Chambord Orosa crayon lipsticks. It's not a recent launch, and I really don't necessarily feature all recent launches on my channel. Although it's much against being smart as a business person on a channel where you need to have a lot of views. I don't know what that says about me, but I am just trying to feature products that I believe should have the love, and I would like to share with you. That is how I prioritize what lipstick I'm going to feature on my channel. This looked very exciting to me. This is the Butter Lipsticks, Orosa Butter Lipstick. This is how this looks. These come with some numbers, and you've got to pull this open. There's this beautiful crayon there which you can open up and then, you know, slide back in. The beauty about these lipsticks is that it is butter-like on your lips. It's very moisturizing. It feels lovely. If you love glosses, you're going to love this. But I think this will stay more than a gloss. And in this format, I think it's a lot easier. You can even use it as a top-up for any lipstick. I do think it is slightly on the expensive side. It's about 1,000, but of course, on the links below, you will find it a little cheaper. But this has 2.7 grams, which is about a little more than half of a bullet lipstick. This costs 1,000, like I said. Do I think it's worth it? I would say that I wish it was 800 bucks. Chambord is a good brand. In fact, it's one of my most favorite brands. All through college and all of that, I used to wear a lot of Chambord. And I think if they've charged over 1,000, they must have added some ingredients, but I wish it was 800. If you read what they have written in their description, it's a high shine butter lipstick which has a gleam of lip gloss and the rich emollient of a lip balm. I think it is meant to serve you as a lip balm. The buttery soft texture melts in your lips, creating a long lasting shine. A sensorial gliding feel with buttery soft texture. Easy to carry, retractable sticks. Achieve dewy, lustrous lips in one application. I agree with this, that this has makhan-like application. It does feel like butter on the lips, and it reminds me of some very expensive lipstick I had from Clinique, which had that butter feel to it when I would apply. And it was exactly like this, actually. It had that little sheen. It had not much color. And I could use it as a lip balm, or I could use it as a lip topper, or I could just use it, you know, like a lip gloss. I think this reminds me of that. But a cheaper version, of course. This shade, what I am wearing, is the shade number 104. I'm not going in a specific order. Peach orange shade, which has specks of gold in it. This is something like if you have a very plain face but you want a little chamak, then this would be lovely. I can't see my lips 100% through it, so I don't have such a big complaint on the pigmentation. If you look at it as a tint, this would be lovely. This has the capacity to make your lips look luscious, make it look very juicy and nice, and you feel nice when you wear these. Like the earlier lipstick video I made, I didn't put any makeup on my face because you all seem to really like that. So I said, alright, I've just dabbed a little powder to just ensure that there's no shine, there is no concealer, nothing, and I of course just did my eyebrows. This is, seems like a very light shade, and actually in the packaging, I would have liked to show you the emblem that they have on it, but of course because I used it, it's got over. Maybe I'll try to show it in another one and show you. Ooh, very nice. It looks nice on my arm. Let me wear it and see. I like the sheen it has. Very, very natural, but you can see the discoloration on my lips through this color. So if you don't have very heavily pigmented lips like mine, you could really wear this well. Can you hear the peacocks? Go on, peacock. I've created a silence for you. So this is the shade, like I said, 103, very natural shade. Will look wonderful for lighter skin girls than me. But if you ask me, even I really like this. I just want to get out of the house. I can just quickly wear this and get out. It's like a light gloss. I like it. Okay, the next shade is shade number 102. Looks pretty close to what I just wore earlier. I'll show you. Oh, this is even lighter than that. But this is more pinkish. And this has that sheen on it that the earlier one didn't have. I'll wear it and show you. This is also a super natural shade, lighter than what I wore earlier. If you want to just have like a lip balm look on your lips, this would be very good. For lighter girls, for girls who don't have so much pigmentation, this would definitely be very nice. Now I'm going to move to 101, which is another nude shade. This is another nude shade. It's very difficult for me to kind of differentiate between these three. 101 is the lightest, 102 is what I wore just before this, and the first one in the nude what I wore was 103, which is the most pink. This is so good for me to wear with this kind of an absolutely no makeup thing. I want to just wear something and get out. This is very much like my lip, but better. I know a lot of you love these kind of nude shades, so I think you're gonna like these. I want to thank each of you who have subscribed to the channel, and for the ones who may not have, just take a second, it's completely free. Just look at the pink smiley you see on the side and go subscribe to the channel, and hitting the notification bell will ensure you do not miss a future post. Okay, this would mean the world to me. It's just a click away for you, but it means like you appreciate what I'm doing here, and I really value that. I'm actually quite excited because along with Joy Geeks, I'm also trying to build my other channel, which is Video Excellence Lab, and it's incredible what some of you folks are doing there, because you know, you want to have your business, you want to create content, so many things, and video is essential, and I'm so happy to be able to help you with video techniques and help you with basic editing stuff, you know, simplified stuff. So check that channel if you haven't already. This is another shade, number 105. This is like a fluorescent peachish orange. I am pretty sure this is not going to look excellent on me like the other four I liked. This I will tell everybody to kind of avoid, honestly, because this is a little patchy. Normally these kind of colors would look lovely on lighter skin girls. But typically coralish fluorescent shades in many brands don't work, and this is exactly like that. So just stay away from these. So far the four I showed you are wonderful, so I think you can ditch this. So I am telling you honestly exactly how I feel about the lipsticks, as usual, and I'm glad you appreciate that. If anybody has that shade and you like the shade, please don't mind. Please enjoy your lipstick. You know, if you're really enjoying it, I'm just saying that it's not working for me. I'll move the pick. So many of them, and I do share a lot of these on my Insta, so you should check that out. The next one is 106, which is again like a fluorescent orange shade. Okay, now I would really wish that you can see that wonderful logo of theirs, which they have inserted there. Yeah, can you see? Yeah, that light. Yeah, can you see that? Ooh, I like these kind of detailings in the lipstick. Even though the outer covering looks fluorescent, and let me show you a swatch. So it is the brightest of them all. I would say that I do like this. I don't think it's patchy or anything. It's in the bright zone. the sweet everyday lip balmish buttery textured lipstick that I think would work across. I'm not sure for very dark girls, but many people, even of my skin tone, may not like this. I think for me, these kind of colors typically work when I'm wearing an all white and then you have a little pop of color. I really like it like that. So what I would say about this is that, of course, it's not transfer proof. It's not going to last you too long, but it's very easy to apply on the go. If you're somebody who likes tints, you would love this. There are many other formulas of Chambord lipsticks that I am trying out, a few of them. Let me know if there's something that you would want to specifically watch. Chambord, like I said earlier, has been a favorite brand since I was in college. Their lipsticks, the matte lipsticks, used to work so well because it would not dry out the lips. So Chambord is a loved brand. It's really crazy that I haven't featured Chambord on my channel at all. Okay, anyway, Derai Durustai, you know. I would love to hear from you if you have tried these, what you feel. Tell me your favorite shade in the comments. And I am looking forward to listening from you, what you want to see more of, because that really helps me. And keep your love coming. I love to read your comments and interact with you. So I will see you in the next video. You take care. Subscribe if you haven't. And I'll see you in the next video.